Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another video, and today we're going to talk about a pen, and it's a really exciting pen, and this is actually one of my Christmas presents, and I'm very grateful that I got this pen here. It's also a pen that came out recently, and I haven't seen any videos here on YouTube that talk about it, so I'm going to show you this pen right now. So of course you can see it is a pen from Lionsteel, and Lionsteel only has released one pen as far as I know, and that is the Nyala pen that they recently released. And now let's open it up. And then here you can see the wooden box that it comes in. You also get a little pamphlet here. You can take a look at that as well, Nyala pen. And then some information about the quality, then the story behind the name. Nyala stands for a South African antelope. And you may know that there is also a fixed blade from Chris Reeve that is called Nyala. Then here you have your warranty, and then some information about the cartridge that it is using, which is a Fisher Space Pen cartridge. So that's that on the pamphlet, and now let's take a look at the pen itself. You can see here it comes really nicely presented in this nice dark wooden box. They also do that for some of their higher end knives, like the titanium SR1s and SR2s, and also their TRE model. But this particular box is a little bit special because it actually has an additional function. You can see if you put it on its back side, it actually works as a stand for your pen. And then here in the back, you can actually put in some business cards, or for a display case, you can actually put in the box cover itself, so it would look like this. So a really nice thing. I think that they have thought a little bit about a secondary use for their box, so very well done there. But now let's get rid of the box and take a look at the pen itself. So here you can see the Nyala pen in its full glory, and you can see that I have the bronze shine version. They also offer this particular model with the ultra dense twist Damasteel insert here on the barrel in a standard silver shine version, so a polished titanium. The whole pen is made out of titanium, and then you have the nice Damascus tube here to give it a little bit of an interesting look, and also tie together the world of knives and the world of pens. So I really like the version with the Damascus or a Damasteel here quite a bit. There is also a version with a carbon fiber tube instead of the Damascus or Damasteel here, and that is also available in a blue anodized titanium, in a polished version, and also in a matte version, as well as the standard polished silver titanium. So I opted for this one here, and I have to say I'm very pleased with how it looks. Really gorgeous, and you can also see that there are some cutouts in the ultra dense twist Damasteel here, and you can see the nicely milled titanium through there. Very nice texture in there. You can also see that you have a lot of little dimples here running around the forward part of the tip, and also on the back you have the same thing. That is actually thought to add a little bit in traction when you're holding the pen. And you also see that this pen is not a clicky or a pull-off cap rider. It is actually a twisty, so you twist that here, and then the pen comes out in the front, and you twist it back, and that works really well as well. You also have some of these dimples on the twisty, and you can see it works really well. You also have a milled titanium clip that looks really nice and also works quite well. Of course, it's a little bit harder to get in and out of the pocket than a spring clip, but if you don't have too thick of pants or shirt pockets, it works really well. You have two screws that secure that clip to the pen. Here I have a little bit of a disappointment. I would like to see these screws sunken down into the clip and not standing out like they do right now, but that is practically the only thing I have to complain here on this clip. It's just really good looking, as well as the rest of the pen. It is also a smaller pen than you would think. It is on the smaller side of pens. It's smaller than a regular pen. Can take a look here against a Carandage, which is a very popular pen in Switzerland, and it's quite a bit smaller than that. And if you take a look at another Fisher space pen here, I have the matte black shuttle space pen. So quite a bit smaller than that as well. Also a really nice pen. I may do a review on this one here if you're interested in the future. Also a nice pen. This one is of course a clicky. And then the last comparison I have here is going to be the Boker KID 50 cal pen in the micarta version, which is a nice bolt action pen, and you can see it's very very close in the length to this pen right here, but much much thinner and of course much much more classy looking. But this is also a nice one. If you're interested, I will do a review on this one as well. Here you can see the micarta body, and then you have your bolt action mechanism here as well. Really strong spring here on this one, which is also a little bit of a complaint, but that's about the size that the Lionsteel Nyala pen has. I can also give you some specs on the pen. So we have a length here on this pen of 11.7 centimeters or 4.6 inches. So as I said, a smaller type of pen, and you have a diameter here of about 1 centimeter or 0.39 inches. So also not a very, very thick pen. Of course, it is going to be thicker than your standard pens if you look at it like this. But I really like a thicker pen in hand because it really feels your hand, and it's also a very, very ergonomic pen. You can see how I hold it like this. You're not going to interfere with these little ridges or cutouts in the Damasteel inlay. But this one actually works well for rotating the pen like this. But for writing, it's a really nice pen, and it just feels really good in hand. And the weight of this pen is actually 30 grams or 1.05 ounces, so also not too heavy, even though it is made out of full titanium as well as the steel inlay. I think the carbon fiber version is going to be a little bit lighter just because it saves a little bit of weight on the tube here. Now let's disassemble the pen and see how it comes apart. So you're just going to screw off here the tip portion, and then the spring comes out. Standard spring here, nothing special. And here you can see the cap from the inside, nice threads. And you also have the Lionsteel logo. I think I haven't showed you that before, here on the tip of the pen as well. And then you take out your refill, and you can see that it is a Fisher Space Pen refill. It's actually marked with Lionsteel, which is a little bit interesting. It is the PR4 pen refill. So actually, I'm not quite sure if you can only get this from Lionsteel or through Lionsteel, or if this is just a little bit of a branding thing. But it certainly is a shorter refill than your regular Fisher Space Pen. If I screw apart my shuttle space pen here, I have a PR1F refill that looks like this. But it's actually the same size, you can see here. It's actually the same size, but this one is a blue refill, and this one is a black one. So you can use practically any Fisher Space Pen refill, I would conclude from that. This one just happened to be branded with Lionsteel, which I think is pretty cool. But this refill works pretty well. I think it's a thicker tip one compared to the one I have on the shuttle pen. But we can further disassemble here the pen. We can take off the ultra dense twist stainless steel barrel and take a look at it separately. So really good looking. I absolutely love how they executed here the Damasteel inlay, one of the main selling points of this pen for me personally. And now we can take a look at the body without the barrel. Nice fluting that they have done here. Really good looking. Just a very well executed pen here. You can also see the threads here on this part of the pen. And just very well made. I'm absolutely in love with this pen, and here you can see it disassembled completely. So overall, I have to say I'm really, really pleased with this pen. I like the overall size. I'm very, very in love with the look of it. You have a nice and crisp bronze anodizing, and the ultra dense twist Damasteel really, really puts it over the top for me because it is just such a nice symbiosis of the pen culture and the knife culture. And I think Lionsteel has executed that masterfully. And I also like that it is a twisty and not a pull-off cap because I actually do not like the capped pens. I think it's just a hassle and you lose the caps and things like that. So I like that it is one contained pen. And the price of this pen is just under $200, if I'm not mistaken. And I think the carbon fiber version is a little bit cheaper. So overall, it's going to be on the upper end of pens. So it's going to be a high-end pen, an expensive one. But I think you're really getting a lot here with the Nyala pen, with the ultra-dense twist Damasteel steel. I'm not aware of any other knife or pen company that offers a pen with Damasteel. So that is certainly a unique selling feature here of this pen. I'm not too fond of the carbon fiber one. I think it looks a little bit too standard because there are a lot of pens with carbon fiber. It's certainly also a nice pen, especially in the blue anodized version. I would also like to see this Damasteel version in some different anodizing colors. But I think the dense twist Damasteel version is certainly where it's at with this pen from Lionsteel. So overall, I'm very, very happy with this pen. I want to thank again my girlfriend for this awesome present, and I would certainly recommend to check it out and see if you're in the market for a higher end pen, if the Lionsteel Nyala is something for you. So that was my little review of this pen, and if you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. I will try to answer you there as soon as possible. And if you want to see more videos about knives, guns, and gear, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.